We draw conclusions all the time. These conclusions might be as a result of us thinking through an argument, because of what someone else is telling us, or as a result of information we get through our senses. However we draw conclusions and make decisions, we know from our earlier work on skepticism that when we reason, we are fallible, which is to say, we may be wrong. Often we need others to check our reasoning for errors, and that can happen in several ways. One way is to see if an argument we think is sound works in convincing others. If we continually fail to do so, we may have made a mistake in reasoning, a mistake others may be kind enough to point out to us. We also attribute credibility based on the recommendation of others. If someone is an expert or has important knowledge that could help us, the manner in which they have convinced others of their importance or usefulness might be a good guide for us. If people around me, who I know can make good decisions, are lending their trust to a particular source, I might be persuaded to do the same. In the same way, if someone or some institution or group of people are known as a bit dodgy, the lack of social credit they have might save me having to find it out for myself. We can also use the direct experience of others to see if the conclusions we draw are able to be generalised over their experiences. In the same way that I know a bit more about lemons by seeing Dave's reaction when he tasted one, and realise it was similar to mine. Our interaction with the physical world is something we master pretty quickly. All animals do this, of course, but humans manipulate the physical world in a way no other animal does. We make and use an astonishing variety of chemicals and materials in our industry, and for use in daily life. This has been made possible in part because we can communicate and confirm things about the world for each other. If someone finds out a particular food is poisonous or that a particular tree makes for a good boat, that can be confirmed by others and then used as a resource for all. The production of iron was a significant event in our culture, and we were able to maximise its effect by explaining how it can be made to others, who would then verify this, check for errors, and perhaps improve the process. And that improvement could also be tested and passed on by others. When we have a reproducible, shareable process of investigating the world, and when that reproduction produces reliable results over time, we have learned something that goes beyond the knowledge we could have produced ourselves, if only because of the large number of people involved in the collective project. Other people, then, are critical in helping us avoid errors in our thinking.